Good evening, everybody. It is Tuesday evening. We're a little late on the podcast, but it's okay because we're cool and we're cool. Two cool dudes. Hold on, I'm on the wrong screen. Two cool dudes. We got me and Starlito.
Yeah.
You know, it's one of those nights that we're just going to talk about whatever the hell we please.
Yeah, we're going to talk about whatever the frick we want. I'm tired and I'm beat.
I can't see what those are.
But that was cool. You're not used to it.
That was cool while it lasted. I'm just kidding.
But yeah.
Oh, shit.
I'm tired. It's been a busy week. And this whole weekend, my body is just catching up. But, how's everybody doing out there? Salute, Los Estres Oro.
Yes.
Los Hermanos 616. And everybody that's been participating in the Black River Studios area. And I want to thank everybody who participated in the sponsorships, which we're going to go in the second here and show our sponsors and show the little bit of love that they gave us. So,
yes. So, tonight we're just going to be random conversation that I just realized I finished my pop. Anyway.
Your what?
My pop.
Your who?
My pop.
Your what?
This.
Oh, soda.
Yes.
Got
it. Oh, that's what was on my finger. Anyway, so tonight we're going to be talking about whatever we... Oh, my lights are falling off. Damn, I got to get new stickers.
Squirrel.
You always say rabbit.
Squirrel.
Squirrely.
I need that squirrel to go across that screen.
I don't know. I'm going to try to figure
it out. In case everybody doesn't know, when you hear squirrel, is because he doesn't pay attention to one little object or one little thing. He focuses on, it's just random things. Yeah. Like we could be talking about something, and all of a sudden he's like, oh, look at that deer.
Yeah.
And we're talking about the conversation.
And we're talking about, like, cars or something.
Talking about cars. Hey, what up, John? Talking about a yo-yo.
John Ortiz is on.
What's up, Johnny John, man?
Coke is not it. It is.
Coke is it, buddy. Coke is it. It's better to sniff it than to taste it. Anyway.
Right.
That junkie joke.
I never did it.
Drink the Coke.
I've never done it. But anyway. We're just, it's a Tuesday night. You know, what's everybody up to?
There's a lot that we've been doing. There's a whole lot.
It is, actually. But
we've been doing a lot. I think we're all tired. We're all exhausted. My eyes are hit so bad. I've been sleeping I think after the podcast, I go to sleep and I don't wake up till the next following day. That's a lot of sleep.
Yeah, that is. And it's only 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got a late start on the podcast tonight, but it's okay because that's what we do. And we do whatever the hell we damn well please.
We do what we want. We grown as adults.
Yep.
We grown as men. We do what we want.
Yep.
You don't like it?
There's the freaking... Wait, hold on. I'll show you. The door's right there. You can see it on the...
I was going to say, man, you can flip up. Scroll up.
Don't scroll, but like, comment,
like, share everything else before you scroll.
Yeah. Anyway. Now we're just having a chill night tonight, and I pushed the wrong button. That's pretty much it. How's everybody's Tuesday going? Go ahead, comment. What up, Dan Gladwell? What up? Oh, I'm like, what the frick? Because I heard it, and I'm like, I thought my headphones were still on. Anyway, we're still looking at that Lions win. I mean, I was going through Facebook.
You still on that?
Well, I was scrolling through Facebook, and I kept seeing all these posts that people were, videos and stuff that other people were posting of, like, different angles, different views. Oh. Of that last kid.
Hey, what's up? What was the number 41? He had like...
Oh, he shit his pants.
He shit his pants, bro. Yes. Like,
and then I said, well, that was one shitty win, though. Yeah, number...
Was it 40, 41?
Something. Yeah, I think so.
I wonder how hard he pushed when he pushed on that mask.
That was funny because I was like, maybe they... he was too excited and didn't want to get out of the game to go take a crap. So they're like, just poop in your...
That is not how that happened. I'm pretty sure he drank the night before on an empty stomach and he had chorro.
Yeah.
Could've you know been. What I mean?
Could have been.
He's like, I could do it. I could do it. Nope, that's not a fart.
That one, yeah. That wasn't a fart. That was.
You're going to play the game anyway, you son.
I pooped my pants. But what a, I mean, imagine you pooping your pants and then it being live on national TV.
Ooh, imagine somebody being next to me as you're on the line. They're like, what the fuck is that?
Did you shit in your pants, dude? Who farted? And it being that bad that you're in the stadium and you can still smell it. Is that
a wig your way?
I don't remember if that was an outdoor stadium. Or is it?
It's outdoor.
Oh. But then again, there's not really that much wind.
But I mean, I guess you wouldn't really tell the difference. I mean, if you're in Houston, there's a lot of farms out there, so.
Yeah. So, yeah, that was even like thinking about that win
and downwind.
The field goal. The what?
The downwind.
Oh, yeah. Imagine that, though, for real, sitting next to that guy in the line, and you're like, what the fuck?
I fell in mud.
Dude, there's no mud out here. But, you know, you would think they would. And I always wondered that about football players, like, some of them are out there, man, bubble guts or whatever. And you're like, man, I got to take a crap.
What about Isaiah Martinez said, hey.
What up, Isaiah? Like you're thinking, like they're out there and they're like, man, I got to take a crap. But then they don't get the opportunity to do it because they're in the middle of playing. And maybe somebody hit him in the stomach and it forced his poop to come out because he had a crap.
You know, you just never know. You really don't know.
Like, you never see football players, I mean, it's not like they're going to announce it, but you never really see football players leaving unless that's sometimes why they take them out of the game. You know, different players.
That's just, you know. You know, let's get off the subject.
No, but for real, I mean.
You're worried about somebody's ass.
No, I'm saying, like, I know, right?
You're focused on somebody's ass. Like,
no, I'm just saying, like football, or basketball players, like, when did Michael Jordan go take a shit? I'm just kidding. Anyway.
Wow.
So.
Now you're on his ass.
So we're getting. Yeah. Now we're. So I just read that we are definitely getting a Marco's Pizza. So there's a sign up. Which is funny because the article said, is there a Marco's Pizza opening up? No, they just put a sign up just to fucking mess with people. What kind of stupid questions?
There's ignorant questions. Okay, there's a lot, and especially on the informed, Holland informed, there's a lot of dumb questions. But again, if you don't like it, scroll.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. But, you know, I was sitting there today, and I'm on my computer, I'm going through the emails, and I'm wondering to myself, this society has gotten so stupid. Lazy.
Oh.
Because instead of actually getting in your car, driving to see if the store is open, they'd rather get on Facebook and go, does anybody know if this store is open? Oh, do you know the hours of this store? I mean, you can literally go on maps.
Website.
You can go to the website and find out the hours. But they'd rather be uninformed and go, does anybody know the hours? Are they open? Like, get in your car. Quit being lazy.
Yeah, I mean, I get it. Maybe you don't have gas, but you should have gas if you're wondering if a store is open. That means you want to go to that store.
Yes, just go for a ride, man.
Yeah, exactly. He said, even though the election is over, people have spoken to me about the possible changes that are supposed to make things better. I don't believe politicians or even politics. You know, Isaiah...
Did we bring up politics?
No, I think it was just something. But here's a question. Here's the thing. I don't believe in politicians either. They're all liars and crooks. But
okay.
The thing is,
he said, "What are your thoughts about the election results?"
I think it's
what about
fair win.
Today was the first perfect day you can come in.
Yeah,
you can come in right now. Sit in.
Yeah. So
Lou's not here, so you can come in.
Yeah. So I think that. The elections were fair. Trump won fair and square because, you know, there wasn't... The funny thing was is you notice how there wasn't any messed up machines, there wasn't anything going crazy, there wasn't any possible let's have some recounts. when Biden was winning. But, you know, it's all like, oh, everything's fine. Trump won fair and square because, you know, that shit ain't going to happen twice. So that's how it is, and that's how it will happen. And if you don't like it, too damn bad. Move on. It happened. It's done.
What's up, Marty?
Hey, Marty, what's up? It's done, and we could all live our lives. Hey, Marty, how you doing?
What you oh my godding about?
Yeah, what are you oh my goshing about? Or oh my goodness is
no,
about?
She said OMG.
What? Oh, because she's mad about the elections.
Are you mad about the elections or what we spoke about earlier about pooping?
Probably the elections.
I'm going to say pooping.
Let's see what she says. Are you mad about the pooping or the elections? Look, if you do this, it looks like a long
What's time. Up, Michelle Carter? Boy, you better quit talking about books.
Ben and his Trump. Hey, it's not my Trump.
Hey,
it's America's
wait,
Trump.
Hang on, hang on. On Ben's defense, he did not bring up any politics. Isaiah Martinez brought it up, not Ben.
Yeah, I didn't say anything.
Ben was but, just terrifying.
But it's okay, though, because we're going to talk about anything. Hey, Michelle, what's going on? Thanks for joining. We appreciate you.
Yeah, shout out to Michelle Crafts. Michelle that's Crafts, inside yep. Miller Inc.
I'm not a bully. I'm just speaking truth, and nobody likes to hear it. That's
ben
all there is.
Not
to
a bully. By far a bully.
Oh, shit. You know what's a bully? This.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, wait. Thanks to Michelle's Crafts, she makes things like this.
Yes.
Check this out.
Yes,
Marcus,
yes.
You got your pen?
I got right here. Look at
you. Go. Even though we don't like that one. I mean, it's still cool.
Eat a dick.
Mighty, you're silly. So, yeah. What'd you say?
Nothing, Ben.
Let me show this real quick. So, this is the bulls, obviously. But when
bullshit.
You go like this, it looks like a longhorn. Yeah. Look at it.
Longhorns are the opposite way, buddy.
What? Is it backwards?
It goes this way. Not up. It goes this way.
I know. That's what I did.
Keep going. Keep going.
I'm not breaking it.
He caught on too quick.
No, it's not, Marty, so don't
ever
say
Michelle
that again.
Said, I got all the pins, keychains, and car diffusers and sit on sale for the rest of the month. All
right. Well, you know what? I do got to go
well,
check out.
Well, see, the diffusers, I believe, are $7. Keychains and pens are $7 or $5, something like that. But if they're going on sale, then, I mean, I'd get in there and get some pens and keychains. Actually, there's a keychain I want, but...
She also makes these cool Halloween ones. Look.
Oh, yeah. Where's my... Oh, they're in my office.
Look at this. Hold on. It's there. Look at that. Look at his little knight.
What's up, Moyo?
Hey, Moyo, how's it going?
So, yeah, if you guys hear any background, just know we have Joey Choi here live making a track with Kalu.
Yep.
And just speaking of, real quick, this Friday, all of us, Black River Studios, will be going to see a live concert with performing Joey Choi and feature... special appearance by Kalu. Yep. So if you guys want to join us out there, it's 1700 Michigan Avenue in Lansing, Michigan.
And you have to pay your way. We don't.
Yeah, pay your way. It's only like, what did they say, $10? $15?
I think it's something like that. Yeah.
Well, yeah, so.
But yeah, you pay your way. We're cool, so we get in, you know, we already got our tickets.
Well, we have passes. But
passes, yeah. Hey, Sunny Ski's on tonight, man.
Moyo's on here, so what up, guys?
Oh, yeah. Oh, what up, Moyo? Yep. I did see his name. Moyo, what's going on, man? Hope everything's going well for you.
Come on, Ben, okay?
What is up with Marty getting all...
You were looking at her boobs last time.
No, I was.
Talking about her, you like her shirt when you were looking at her boobs.
It was Michael Myers, and she went
you
like
can call
this.
Her boobs wherever you want.
She went like this, and that's when I saw the
that's because you were looking at her boobs.
Marty, was I looking at your boobs?
She went like this, and you saw what was
she
on her
said
counter.
Shut. She said shut up.
Shut up. Marcos.
I wasn't looking at your boobs, Marty. I was looking at your shirt.
You lie. Don't make me call Lou in here.
Marcos.
Don't make me call Lou in here.
Okay, so. He wasn't here that day.
Yeah, he was. We were outside teasing you.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And she said, Ben, yes, you were looking at her boot.
No, I wasn't.
Michelle said the pins are $5, keychains are $4, and car diffusers are $4 till the end of the month.
But when we were recording the video, I wasn't looking at anybody's boobs. What is... I mean...
See, Miss Maddie was live.
Call him.
Maddie was live.
Oh.
Oh, Moyo.
Oh, that video.
Hang on, I will. I'm going to call.
Call who? Oh, Lou. He's over there.
Is he?
Is he? I don't know where he went. Anyway, I wasn't looking at anybody's boobs. I was like, she had a Michael Myers shirt on, and she went like this, like, you could see the face, and what up, Mark? And anyway, so, and that's what happened. So, is he coming in here? Lou, was I looking at his boobs that day?
What's up?
Okay.
What are you talking about?
Remember, Marty was live.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
And he was looking at her boobs. And we teased him, right? We were teasing him.
Oh, yeah, we were teasing him.
Why? Because, well, he was looking at her boobs.
Did I say I was looking at her boobs? Did I actually say that I was?
Yes, you did.
I don't remember that.
I think you did.
Told you. Bam. Thank
How
you.
Am I looking at
Have a good night, buddy. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Lou.
I'm sorry. Hey, real quick, though, man. That was happening next door.
Mighty said hi.
Y'all better be ready.
You heard that? Y'all better be ready.
So we're thanks. In the booth right now.
Moyle said, tell the truth, Lou.
Okay, Lou. Hey, I did. I told him. I said, yeah.
I told you, stop me when I lie. Thank you, Lou.
Stop me when I lie. Only so because stop he had Michael Myers shirt on. He did it, the Lou. No, I didn't. What are you? I was barely by you that day. Except for when we were eating.
Except for when you were eating? That's not something to say in the same sentence, Ben.
I mean, you know what I mean. Oh, man. But anyways, I wasn't looking at anybody's boobs or tits or...
Is tits a word still?
Anyway. I wasn't looking at boobies.
Bro, quit lying, bro.
How? I was admiring her shirt. Remember, Marcos, he said he would use the footage for the video of my boobs. Oh, yeah. I remember that now. Boobs, though. I mean...
Stop me when I lie.
Oh, man, that's...
Stop me when I lie.
Something on my nose.
She said she'll give you the shirt, Ben.
Okay, I'll take
it. He doesn't want the shirt. He wants the boobs.
I'm married. I got my own wife's boobs.
Hey... Two pairs ain't gonna hurt.
All right, you're just gonna get me divorced. Anyway.
Hey, everybody knows we just joke around.
Yeah,
here.
We're just joking. I didn't really look at
it. But I did tell the truth. I even brought Lou in here to tell the truth, and Ben and Lou told the truth.
Oops. No. Can help. What?
Nope. Can't be there. Bye. Bye, Felicia.
This is the funniest broadcast of your show that I've ever viewed. Thanks.
Man, we tried.
You should have seen the other day.
Go to Monday. Isaiah, go to Monday.
Yes, check out
Monday's podcast.
No, it was Friday night.
Was it Friday night? Yeah. Oh, yes, Friday night.
Last Friday.
We were so exhausted.
Sound like Ben's lying.
Ben is lying.
Okay. You know what? The boobs were there. Well, I mean, not like in person. I mean, I could see her shirt. I mean, she had a shirt on. How,
but
you know,
the boobs just
anybody that walks past that has boobs, of course you're going to see the boobs bouncing. I mean, when they're walking. I mean, how are you not going to notice boobs moving?
No, shut
pop. If you're walking and the boobs are moving, you're going to see. I mean, how hard is that?
Ben.
She said Topsy.
While you're ahead.
Anyways, the boobs were there. I'm sorry. Anyways.
Love you too, Marty.
Next up. All right, Marty. Have a good night, mija. We love you.
Mija.
I'm sorry. I didn't know why I said that.
Oh, boobs, mija.
Yes, Moyo. I mean, not like purposely, but they were
fire.
There. No, hold on a minute. Let me finish my sentence. They were there. They were bouncing. And I glanced because I'm filming. So I kind of like went like this. And I was like, there's boobs bouncing over there. And that's what happened. And that's
you
all
can
that.
Tell your story all the way you want, man. I have video on it.
What does Ijole mean?
Ijole.
Oh, okay. Never mind. I'm dumb. So, say that again.
He said stop. They're not bouncing.
It was when you were walking towards the,
Ben, shut
okay,
up,
I'm done.
Bro.
Okay, we're done with that.
You're
stuff.
Just...
I'm just digging myself into a deeper hole. Here, let me get out of that hole real quick. There, I'm out of the hole.
You're not out of the hole.
Okay,
yes,
so,
there's video of Moyo.
Wait, what video? I didn't film her.
I did. Remember you were on the video camera, and she said she, I was going to use it towards... With,
yeah, that's
as
right.
Evidence that you were looking at boobs. You were literally staring at her boobs. Okay, enough with Marty's boobs.
Okay, enough of that. So, another subject.
No.
Go ahead.
Said there's plenty to go around.
Yeah. Plenty of boobies to go around. Okay. Trump and Ben are besties.
They are. They share the same hairline.
Whatever. Do I really?
No. He's going to toupee, fool.
Oh, that's right. He does. Anyway, so, yep, Trump won. I mean, we all get that part. But, and that's pretty much it. Because we got a good show to coming up on Friday, November 15th in Lansing. So, yeah, we're excited.
It is a full concert.
We're having fun. We're excited.
It is a huge concert, and Joey Ochoa will be one of the artists that there, mm-hmm. but featuring with Joey will be Kalu.
Mm-hmm.
Which we're all excited because, I mean, things are just blowing up as days go by.
You need a recount. I don't think that's going to happen this
that's
time.
That's not going to happen.
I think they're done in pet. I think we're...
by far, people want Trump to be hitting
anyway. I mean, exactly, because...
Wait, a recount of the boobs or a recount of the election?
Oh, do you want to... Yeah, do you want us to refilm the boobs or do you want... What do you want? I don't know. I'm just kidding. Of course you do, Marty. Well, there ain't going to be no recount this time around because...
Anyway, it's just 4 years. People get over it.
And this is his last 4 years, so
last 4 years, that's it. Last
and
4 years.
Then the...
we'll deal with it for
and
4 years.
Harris will try to go in again and then ruin the country again. Okay.
No, but by then they're going to have the other... What's his name?
Oh, or J.D. Vance...
Yes.
...could become president after that. So that's what
and
we're...
And then we'll all be going to hell.
What did she say? No recount of boobs. It's only two.
You don't want to see my boobs. Just
no
start
boobs.
Drooling.
Show your
boobs. You don't ruin your
I was going to call you boobs.
Boobs, show your Marcos.
Your bone, buddy.
Boobs, show your Marcos. Anyway, no Trump will do that all by himself with Vans. J.D. Vance. His name is Vance. Because we're going to advance in the United States.
I wish people were here so they could see the studio. That whole room over there is packed.
Who's all in there?
All right, everybody.
Well, let me check.
No, that's just Joey in there.
Oh. What up, Joey? Joey's in the house. So, anyway. But, yeah, we're... I think America's gonna JD advance because we're gonna grow. And can I? Yes, Isaiah, you can ask a question. Go ahead. And Marty, I'm not dreaming.
He's already had his dream come true. You've already seen your boobs.
I never. You know,
stop that while you're ahead. You know, Linda Love.
Linda Love. Linda Uluv. Yeah, type your question. I'm waiting. Okay. Linda loves watching. So, no, we're like, oh, wait, before you ask your question, I'm going to go to our commercial break and show our sponsor.
Shout out to Emily.
Emily from Papa John's, but we'll be right back.
This episode is brought to you by Papa John's, 280 North River Avenue, right here in Holland. Give them a call, 616-355-7272. Southside Cuts, with two locations, 114 West 16th or 375 Columbia Avenue, 616-836-7502. They're open weekly 10 to 8. Pure West Compassion Club, located at 9730 Adams Street, Holland, Michigan. Get a hold of them, 616-772-9420, or visit their website at purewestclub.com.
Okay, we're back. What's going on, everybody? Let's go ahead and answer Isaiah this question. Isaiah said,
who got more boobs, Trump or Mahdi? By far, Mahdi.
Yeah, Mahdi has... I'm not even going to answer that.
She beat Dolly Parton by its size.
Okay. Say that again?
I said she beat Dolly Parton by its size.
Oh, yeah, that's very true. But here's the thing is...
Mahdi says Ben has more...
I don't have boobs. You're the reason I'm not in my back, isn't it? I got nipples and that's all I got. Anyway.
That was too easy. I'm just going to shut up on that one. I'm talking to you.
Oh. Stop it.
Stop it.
Buddy, you're silly. All right. So, yeah, definitely, like I said, we got a good show coming up. Friday, November 15th, in Lansing, Michigan. Joey is part of the show with special guest Kalu. It's going to be fun. It's going to be cool. I'm excited.
It's going to be a long night.
And film again, get some shots, and just punch someone. No, I'm just kidding. We're not going to punch anybody. But no, we're just going
to
have fun.
That'd be the wrong area to be punching somebody.
My ear won't start itching.
Good thing about boobs.
Mm-hmm.
So,
I'm in here.
So, anybody know the answer to this? What does a small puppy and a nearsighted gynecologist have in common? Ben, do you know?
No.
They both have nose, cold noses.
Oh, my God.
December 6th, Los Estrellas de Oro will be going to San Antonio.
Fantástico. Los Estrellas de Oro. I almost said it right.
Don't forget to vote for them. Three categories, conjunto awards.
Don't forget to vote for... Oh, I voted for them already.
Oh, I voted for them.
Awards.
I tried to go on a different... my other email, mm-hmm. but it knows me too much. It said I can only vote once.
Yeah, because I'm like, because the ones that Marty's put on there, I clicked on the link and it took me, just kidding. Never mind. Has anybody noticed,
Isaiah said he just got back from San Antonio on Monday morning. And Marty said, you better.
Oh, I was just joking anyways. But no, I was going to say.
I want to go to San Antonio with the guys.
That would be cool. But, did anybody see that article about the Wicked Dolls accidentally post or the boxes have a porn site on it?
Well, no, hang up.
Wicked.com.
Come correct that. They accidentally did a typo.
They used the wrong website.
They used the wrong website. And they did a typo to where if you wanted to see the toys and you went to www.wicked.com, it would take you to the toy site. But the way they spelt it on the box, it goes www.wicked with a D, no E, .com, and it takes you to a porn site.
Yep. So, yeah.
Be careful. If your kids have toys and they got that the website on it, don't click on it and don't let your kids get on it.
Yes.
I would actually double check the website before you let your kids get on it.
Yes, exactly. Marty, what video are you talking about? From Reynosa? Who's Reynosa?
Reynosa, Texas, bro.
I don't know any towns in Texas except for Georgetown and Austin.
You are
and
so
white. Houston.
Houston? Oh, yeah. So, speaking of
pedophiles. Waco and Jona.
Let's get on the Trump thing. But speaking of pedophiles.
Reynosa is not Texas.
Okay.
Well, it sounded like Texas.
Apolupas, Mexico.
Oh.
Okay, I don't know where she was going with that. Anyway. What do you think, Ben?
What?
Let's just say you moved on. And you got divorced, and you ended up dating a girl. But, let's not put you in there because that's a whole other situation.
We'll just use some random
person. Okay, let's use a random guy. There's a random guy. He leaves a woman's house because he doesn't want to be with her anymore. Goes and starts to try to live with another woman. But in the background, he has two charges with him being a pedophile. Would you, as a mom... Or would any moms out there allow this guy to be around her kids?
Hell no. No, fuck that. No, I would be like, if I was a woman in that position and found out, I would not be in that.
Would you even be in the relationship? Knowing that it could or possibly happen to your kids?
No.
So, even though there's charges pending... And you, this person told lies, saying, no, my ex is just talking a bunch of shit and trying to get me in trouble, but yet you have a court date for CSC.
Yeah, I would not be involved in that.
But yet, this woman is thinking about moving in with him.
With the kids?
No, with just him. And the person doesn't know if the kids will be involved or not. But you're choosing the person that has two charges... Over to the children.
Yeah, that person then probably needs to be slapped in the face. And some reality hitting that person.
I'm just thinking out loud. There's several situations that are happening here in Holland. Several cases in Holland. You guys, I'm just going to be real. Mm-hmm. Men... You guys got to do better. These women, I mean, while you're over here entertaining, and trust me, I'm as guilty as anybody else when it came to this.
Yeah.
Entertaining people for their pleasure and for because you're making them laugh or because you're doing whatever it is, and you're spending money on your friends because you know what, homies, hoes before bros.
Right.
Bros before hoes. anyways.
What's that even?
Here's the thing. If you have a family at home drowning... You have no reason being out in the street,
right?
If your spouse is paying for everything for you, and you're out there spending your own money, mm-hmm. and you're not spending any time with family, you have no reason to be on the street,
right? Exactly.
If you cannot be a man with your spouse or be a real woman to your man, don't be on the street trying to be somebody you're not. Like I said, I'm far from perfect, and I did that entertaining. I lost my family because of the entertaining bit.
Yeah.
But this is where, you know, I have these rules in the studio, and you know my rules. Mm-hmm. And family comes first. Doesn't matter what is going on here. If one of the spouses speak, you are to listen.
Right.
Please, by all means, if you do not feel any type of weight towards your spouse, please leave the relationship. Don't be cheating on people.
Exactly.
It is that simple. And then pay attention to the people they're hanging out with, because now there is so many situations where not only men, but women are pedophiles.
Yeah.
And they're using the children as pawns, right. And using the children for sexual pleasures. And nobody's speaking about that.
You know, and it's crazy because, that situation that happened not too long ago. And then...
This is how real this got because nobody's starting. They already quit commenting.
Oh. it's like... almost felt like it was, you know what I'm talking about, of the laminator.
Yep.
Okay.
Oh, yes, yes, so yes. That situation
seriously got out of hand.
That got way out of hand.
And so that's the part where I'm like.
But see, even in that same situation, how could you do it to your own daughter?
Right, exactly.
That's what I'm saying. There's so many situations here in Holland, and everybody is putting their horses' blinds. They're all like this.
Right.
They don't want to see it. They don't want to hear it. But it's happening in their own home.
Yeah, exactly.
And it's just like, pay attention, people. There's a lot of dangerous crap that's happening, and everybody's just being blind to it because they don't want to deal with it.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, exactly. I could care two shits of what people feel because kids are being hurt.
Right.
Exactly. And one thing everybody knows here is that I love kids. Yep. You know, exactly. It's just the kids, they come here, they're always like, when we pick them up and, you know, play with them.
Right.
And it's just like, I get that. I have a business to run. However, go back to mommy.
Right.
I'm busy. But no, you know, in all aspects, man, you got to be careful who you put around your kids. First and foremost, you know what I mean? Those kids are suffering. And because you either want to party or because you want to spread your legs to get rent paid or because you want to live off of somebody, stop. Just stop. Just stop.
Exactly.
It's so demeaning, and it's. Doesn't make you look good. You look more like an arse than anybody else.
Well, in America, you're an ass.
Yeah. But what I'm saying is, it just pisses me off, man. I mean, it happens to the closest of, you know, the close family members that get, you know, abused, and you don't find out till later, and it's too late, and you can't do nothing about it. Versus, you know about it, and you're still not doing nothing about it. And that person's here to deal with it.
Yeah.
But you're still not doing nothing. That's what pisses me off.
Right. So, to me, honestly, I wouldn't allow
it. You got to be a dumbass to let somebody come into your house knowing you got kids and the person's a pedophile.
Right.
You got to be one stupid, ignorant fool.
Yep.
I was going to use another word.
Did you say an April fool?
Yeah, an April fool. Ignorant fool.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you can't be that damn naive to sit there and go, oh, it's not going to happen to my kids.
Right.
Bullshit. Exactly.
Because
give them the opportunity. Give that person the opportunity.
Exactly.
They will take upon themselves to.
It's almost like.
Think it's okay.
Like you're saying, I don't want drugs around my kids, but I'm doing drugs myself.
Okay.
You know, it's pretty much saying that. And so, yeah, I get that. That's like, I would never put. My kids.
Never put kids in danger. Why would you do that?
Exactly.
And just for the guy, just want a place to live or somebody to sleep with, he tells a lie. He says, oh, they're just lying about me because they you know, they owe me money or because they want me back and this and that and that and this.
Yeah.
Boy, don't get your head out of your ass. You know, and that, you know, in conversations, I was asking us how things are going to be handled.
Right.
Because there's a legal way to handle it, and then there's a not legal way to handle it.
Exactly. Exactly.
And, well, I mean, everybody out of anger speaks about handling it a certain way. And, you know, you got to be the voice of reason and say, well, how about doing it the legal way?
Right.
That way nobody gets in trouble.
Exactly.
Except for the person who has to get in trouble. Because if you're not supposed to be around kids and you're living with them, that's two different situations.
Exactly. And so it's like, it's almost like, how would you even word that? Almost like they're asking for trouble, pretty much. Digging themselves
in. You're digging, bro. And it's like, you're on some kind of stupid.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
You're on some kind of stupid.
It's like
you put yourself in your own predicament, and you wonder why people are talking crap about you.
Right. Exactly.
Bro.
Yeah. Exactly.
You have a record.
It's.
and you put yourself back in a situation that you have a record from, and you're not to be around kids, and yet you're around kids.
Right.
Because you want to lay next to somebody.
Because you want that feeling. What up, Juan? What up, James and Matt? What's going on, everybody? Thanks for joining.
But yeah, so man, in all aspects, man, watch your kids and watch who they are around. There exactly. are people out there that look as innocent as a butterfly, but are lethal as a venomous cobra. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
And they're just plain evil. And like again, it's not just men who are pedophiles. Women are out there being pedophiles.
Right.
Exactly. And nobody's saying nothing about it.
Look at those people that used to sleep with kids, with teachers that used to sleep with students.
Leave my teacher out of this.
Yeah.
She was good looking. Anyway, that's not about me. Ben.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah. But also, what I did want to share today, too, is there's been some businesses, or a business, that got broken into. What up, Lou? Lou's back.
Lou wasn't feeling so well. Looks like he's feeling a little better.
Business that got broken into on the south side of Holland.
Oh, yes. You know what?
And
I got a lot to say about that.
You got to be a stupid motherfucker
Whoa.
To do that.
Oh, we've been talking.
Knowing that. Damn well, you were probably just there the day before. Because that's how
you were scoping that shit out. Because you knew exactly what you were looking for, and you went right to it.
Exactly.
Even the cops, if the cops can't figure that much out.
If they can't figure that out, then they need to be punched.
And anybody punched. Trying to sell it, I'll tell you what.
Yeah.
You're a fucking heap of shit.
Yeah, exactly. Because it's like, almost like, okay, so they were there. They obviously were there. They obviously knew what was going on. So
they scoped that place out really good.
And then the next day that it happens.
Yep.
And probably knew they're not open up. Was it Sunday?
It was Sunday.
Sunday morning. So they knew that business wasn't open. So, you know, something happened there.
Word of warning, better not nobody come sniffing around here.
Yeah.
Oh, we got too many things.
We got the pit bull down here,
mm-hmm.
got the cameras, and then you got the Rottweiler upstairs.
Exactly.
You don't want to mess with them.
Hey, I'm just saying.
I'm gonna ask Lou. Let's see his reaction. Put the camera on here.
Oh.
Put the camera on here.
What?
Okay. I just asked Ben. If you knew that your ex had a guy trying staying with her or, you know, visiting her, and he's a pedophile.
Oh, boy.
How would you react knowing that she has somebody in that house with your children inside?
My reaction would be an action.
Okay, see? How?
I'm not going to incriminate myself, but...
Okay.
So, let's see. Paulie would go grab him by the hair, pull him out, kick him in the fucking culo, tell him to get on. All right? That's what Paulie would do. All right?
Okay.
So, no questions asked there. And then
I'd
probably grab my ex and send her right along with Paulie, or right along with the other dude out the door, and then grab my kid.
Okay.
That's my reaction.
Because I'm telling you, there's several situations happening where it's not just women, but men, or not just men, it's women as well that are pedophiles, and
right.
they're allowing other people to come in, knowing their records, and yet being around their kids.
Right.
And it's just okay. like, how is this even,
okay.
And then knowing that this person has a record, she still allowed him to come in.
Pedophiles, right? Okay. They, in a sense, deserve a second chance, right? In a sense.
Okay.
To work, right?
Right.
Or whatever. But I think, and no, for no reason, you screwed that up when you made that decision to mess with kids. Mm-hmm. You do not deserve to be around kids. Period.
Right.
That's my opinion of it.
Exactly.
Period. That's my opinion. That's my opinion, and that's how it, in a sense, in my head, it should be. You know what I mean? You shouldn't.
Exactly.
You basically took that away from yourself.
Exactly.
That person, you know, we reap what we sow, the Bible says, right?
Yes.
So that's part of reaping, that's part of sowing, right?
Mm-hmm.
So he's living that out. He's got to live that out. That's his mistake,
yep.
right?
You can do what you want, but you can never escape the consequences.
Right.
Exactly. Okay. So
because the consequences are coming really quick, and trust me, they're not nice.
Yep. So mm-hmm. you know that right there, yeah, that's just no. That's a no-no. You know what I mean? And I like I said, job-wise, everybody needs to live and eat, right?
Okay. I get that. I get that.
And that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. So by no means don't think I'm, you know, but they do deserve a second chance to work. Right. Not to be around any kids or right. anything. Not even around animals in my consideration.
Yeah,
I'm just saying. That's because, I mean, they might molest my animal, shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That'd be something to catch someone mess around with my dog.
Yeah.
Right.
That would be.
Bro. Now I'm going to get Barkles going.
So I'm going to stop.
Like
that.
I'm going to stop. But you guys get what I'm saying, right? You guys get what I'm saying, though, right?
Yeah. We get it. It was just. So there's several conversations that were happening before the podcast, and you know, it's just like.
I got a pimple on my back.
There's just no reason for someone to leave a relationship and then all of a sudden knowing the history of this person and then going, oh, they were just lying about me because they want money or because, you know.
I've heard of females or males
mm-hmm.
leaving their kids because.
What did I say?
Because yeah. the person that they're with has kids and they don't want their kids around them, but they want to be with them.
Exactly.
What did I say? Okay, exactly. Before you walked in, I said that this person is going to leave her kids to go be with this guy that she knows is a pedophile.
Now that's wrong because...
I rest my case.
To me, you know, not passing judgment or nothing, but to me, in my morally, it's wrong, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I get it. You love him or he loves you or whatever.
In 2 weeks?
But I know, but just wait a minute. At the same time, you have a bigger responsibility when you're a mother or a father.
With your kids, exactly.
Towards your kids. Mm. And I'm pretty sure your kids find out, especially if you got older kids, they're not going to want, it's not a pass. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
It's not a pass because this world is slowly starting to say it's okay to do that.
Right.
Okay? You see how that's transitioning, right?
Mm-hmm.
People are getting away with sex trafficking, with human trafficking, kids. That's just, they're slowly trying to implement that into us, into our society, and make that a point to where, okay, they it's okay for them to do that. No, it's not. It's not okay. It's not okay for you to go molest my cousin or my aunt or whatever happened. You know what I mean? Because there's history of that.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
People need to stand their ground and be like, no. And yes, you can work. No, you can't be around any more kids. Right. That's gone.
Mm-hmm.
So, I rest my case.
That makes sense. In all aspects, if you know somebody who is being molested, anybody who's being hurt, anybody who is, you know,
call CPS.
Don't have a voice, you can come talk to us and we'll handle it legally.
Yeah.
Through the courts and through the police. Otherwise, you can do it yourself. If you think it's, you know, people are going to find out who you are, we will keep it all confidential. Just mm-hmm. make sure that the kids are being protected at 100% of the time. There's enough kids being hurt. And
exactly.
You know, we don't need that.
Yep. And then, you know, exactly. Like, you know, like with that being said, Marcos, you know, we've all failed. You know, we're not perfect. We don't get
any... As I said before.
We don't get an instruction book when we have our kids. It's just go out and learn as you go, right?
Let's learn as you go.
We trust family members. Right. We trust, you know, and then those people are. It's crazy because a lot of the times it is a family member that's doing that.
And that's what I said before.
You know what I mean? And that's sad. And that's sad.
Right.
You know, exactly. It's sad that you can't even trust your own family members,
mm-hmm.
or even people don't want to leave their kids at daycares. Yeah. So that handicaps that person that's very protective over their kids. I do not fault anybody that is protective, any mother, period, or any father. That is like this with their kids.
For sure.
Not at all. Because that's their prerogative. Because, of course, something has happened to them, and they're just expressing the way they've been. But I can see overprotection. Mm-hmm. But to me, when it comes to your kids and they're at a small, innocent age, there's no type of overprotection there. Because God doesn't overprotect us. He protects us, period.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So, him being the father, you know what I'm saying, of all of us, it just makes sense that way, don't it?
It does.
So,
and that's why, you know, speaking with Ben and to these people, but they're crickets right now. As soon as I started being real, there's like cricket. Because it is true, these kids are being hurt. Something needs to get done. And, you know, we're adults. We need to handle that.
Yeah.
And then, and if you can't be an adult about it, you know, go to
sleep. But sometimes, you know, when we think, okay, nobody's doing nothing about it, man, God's got a plan.
Oh, he does.
Y'all better watch out, because that's better than our plan. Oh, better yeah. than our, his vengeance is worse than what we want.
Mm-hmm.
So okay. The consequences of what he has for people is worse than what we could ever imagine.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, and with that, you know, staying in my head, I've come across a lot of stuff in my life where, man, I've never gotten even. But God is like, look
God
at him.
Together.
He's looking at him. Look at him now. You know, look at what's happened. You mm-hmm. know what I mean? And that's going, you know. So, you know, and sometimes when you see what happens, it's like, dang, I kind of feel bad for them. You know, that's it. It's like, man. But I think also, too, that's kind of a little conviction of thinking, like, man, I could have done that. You know what I mean? But God took care of that. And but that's kind of feeling bad. Like, as God has us do, right? He has us feel bad for the situations that he does. Because why? Because he says, look what I did. I took care of it. And that's the thing that I worry about. So I don't know why I'm preaching like that. But, you know.
All it takes is just one question, and everything that's built inside you comes out. And that's why I want people to understand that when I speak about something like this, it's because people have been molested. I have people that have been hurt by men or by women.
So it sits close to home.
And it sits real close to home, mm-hmm. and it pisses me off.
Yeah. Yeah.
To the point where I'm going to take my pastor hat off and I'm going to be the thug that mm-hmm. I don't want to be.
Yeah.
And it's just like, I told the person, so you let me know how you want to handle it, because I'll go both ways. I'll either go to the court or I'll go on it by myself. I'll go to the person's house.
Exactly.
I don't care.
Yeah.
But to put myself in that predicament, I can do what I want, but the consequences I'll suffer later. But it's going to be worth it at the end.
Right.
On my part, not by God's part.
Right. You're right.
Because his flesh.
Stepping into the flesh like that, right? We still got consequence stance to ourselves.
Correct.
So, you know, it's kind of like a double-double, you know? Where they have to pay for it too, but same time, God says, you know what, you can't go unpunished either.
And you know, and sometimes you have to look at it too, because sometimes the system will fail you.
Yes.
Yeah, it does. It will. The society, the systems, yeah. We were just talking about that yesterday, mm-hmm. it's set up to fail.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, they just, you know, they police us the way they want, they convict who they want,
mm-hmm.
and especially if you have a back record of, say, you know, violence or whatever, you know.
What?
They look at you like, man, you ain't been here in 10 years, but you know what? You got a whole lot of right. shit. And,
dude, my record.
But yeah, exactly. You know, and that goes with everybody. I mean, you know, a lot of people we know, you know, that's ran the mm-hmm. same lifestyle we have back in the day, you know, the dope boy ways, the gangbanging ways and all that. You know, we can get into that too. And sit there and analyze it and pick it apart, right? But this is where we're at now.
But see, again,
but we only have like this much room.
Yeah,
maybe.
But see, that's why I told Ben, somebody has to be the voice of reason.
Right, exactly.
You know what I mean? Because without the voice of reason, we go on action.
Yep.
Yeah.
Because we're not going to voice them that. Yeah, right. Action.
Exactly.
That's why, you know, and everybody's like, your reaction. That's a nah. So my reaction would be an action.
Yeah.
You know.
So
I would definitely sit there and
you know. So everybody out there, I mean, I know it's probably personal to you, but I mean, you got to check your kids, check everybody around you with kids, and find out if the kids are all okay. If things are, I mean, I'm not trying to pull scabs or nothing like that, but
mm-hmm.
I mean,
kids will tell though.
Some will say something, some won't.
But their
some are not actions, old enough too.
But yeah. But their actions later on are going to tell you. That tells them to put.
So mm-hmm. just watch the kids, and if you know something's happening, come talk to us, and we'll handle it, or handle it by calling CPS or, you know, the police.
Exactly. So look, Eric came in here too to tell you guys the song's finished. You know,
already.
They killed the song. It's called "Smile on Your Face." Joel Chubb.
Smile in your face.
Yeah.
K-Lou featuring Joey Chow, man, they killed it. They killed it. We're going to have an exclusive release party coming out. We're going to do, right?
Yes.
Yeah. We're going to do all that. We're going to actually.
We weren't actually telling them anything.
Well,
just for an 8-hill, we had a concert.
Yeah, and then the concert's coming up Friday. But before the song's released, we're not going to leak it. We might do a little teaser.
Yeah, I won't even do a teaser.
No. Anyways,
sorry, guys.
We'll be performed at the concert.
Yes, it will be performed at the concert. So if you want to hear the song, you have to get to the concert.
Yes, because you don't get to, get, you know, there's no freebies.
No, but guys, I'm serious. This is going to be a world premiere series, man. This thing's, it's dope. It's going to go viral. I have a feeling. Well,
are we going to be able to hear it when we get out?
Yes. So, yeah, so with that being set up, we need you guys for photos.
Yes.
So,
I definitely
encourage everybody that's watching, look out for Kalu and Joey Ochoa, smile on your face, man.
Boy, it's finished.
It's gonna be off the chain.
That's awesome, because I was hoping they can come in here and just do a little smile.
Let me see if I can get them in here.
Let's see if we can get them in here. Yeah,
get in here. Just
since the song's done, bring a chair too. Hi.
Just say what's up. So definitely, so on that note, yeah, you know, pay attention to who you bring around your kids.
Yes.
So,
you're going to come across.
Yeah, we got off of the.
You're going to come across somebody who is not going to be as nice as we are right now, and they're going to take care of it.
Have a seat.
Right. Exactly.
So
we got DJ Alpha.
We got Alpha One Records. Dang, that's gonna be hard to say. Yes. Alpha One Records. There we go.
So
if you want to give a little Friday, details,
Joey. Friday.
Yeah. So yeah, we got the show Friday. Yep. We're gonna be back in Lansing. There's a nice R&B hip hop show. So Joey Ochoa is gonna be performing live. He has a live set. You know, I'm going to be mixing down the set for him. This time around, we got Kalu's going to pull up. So we did a feature. We got a feature knocked out today.
Yes.
And we're going to go hit, you know, hit the stage over there in Lansing, get in front of a bigger crowd, you know, to see what happens over there. It's going to be see what the crowd responds to, you know, new artists, our artist, Kalu, you know.
Yep.
So
everybody, I'm going to say this live right here, that we got Alpha. Kalu signed with Alpha One Records right here. Mm-hmm. So... Yeah. That's our first artist, the agent of Black River Studios and Alpha One Music.
Good job.
Two Spawns coming next.
Proud of everybody.
So,
there's some music videos on the way.
The address to the event is 1700 Michigan Avenue, Lansing, Michigan. $15 at the door. So get there early so you can get a good spot, because it is general admission, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So get there early, get your spot. Mm-hmm. Can't have my spot because I got the stage. So. Show Friday, 1700 Michigan Avenue in Lansing, Michigan.
That's the plans.
This Friday. So don't be late.
Regardless, we got, you
starts
know,
starts at 10, right?
616 in the building out there.
616, baby.
616.
616 right there.
6 about to take over.
What is it? 616.
Show off our artists, you know, open some more doors, meet some people, promoters, meet some promoters, managers, and other artists, things like that. Just keep things moving along, you know.
2025, man.
Get some footage of the show. Pictures. It's going to be freaking awesome. We're excited. We're very excited, actually, to be a part of it.
And I'll tell you guys right now, that song that they just dropped, it's a vibe for everybody. That vibe, it's a radio play song.
It's something. I've heard the beginning of it. I like it.
Our product's going to be mixed by T. Can't forget about T and our sound engineer. Yeah.
Let's just say it's something special.
Yeah. Shout out to T, our sound engineer.
Joey.
Kalu.
I can't wait to be here. We got some photos.
So 2025, we have a lot going on, and we are going to explode. Yes. We're going to be taking over Holland soon. So.
It's going to be called Holland. Or, wait, how do you say it?
Holland.
Holland.
That one. No. Orlando. Or
Holland.
How would you say it in Spanish?
Holando.
He's stupid.
That's a good one. Orlando. It's going to be called Orlando by the end of the next year. We got F1 Records. Already kicking ass, and it's just the beginning of it. So we're all excited. We're having fun with this, and it's like, I don't need, it's just too much for words.
Our doors are open, man. And you know, so, yeah. Recording artists out there, come through, come see the
Tito. Female recording artists.
Female recording artists. We urge you guys to come out, man.
Trying to do features, all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
We're going to need some movie fill-ins.
We need some extras.
Extras.
for videos and movies.
And anybody famous that wants to do a cameo, okay. We'll take Ice Cube.
Yeah. Hell yeah, you want to do a cameo? Come on, dude.
Ice Cube, Snoop, who else is out there? Eminem, Snow.
But would that be so?
Oh, God, no, he did not say Snow. Yeah.
These guys. Snow and maybe some TLC.
Yeah. All right, y'all.
All right.
Yeah, have a good night.
Thanks, T. Alpha One Music. Alpha One Music. So yeah, that we got a good show coming up. Everybody, you better be there. Be there or be a freaking loser. I'm kidding. I'm joking.
Damn.
I'm kidding. But be square, though.
Damn. You're all ruthless. You get around rappers and stuff, you become ruthless. This ain't Ruthless Records.
Yeah, I know, right? We can.
Suge Knight over here.
I'm just kidding. Suge Knight. But anyways, what time is it?
It's almost closing time.
Oh, yeah, it is, pretty much.
Oh it crap, is.
It's already 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we better log off here.
Show sponsors.
Sponsors one more time. And we will be right back real quick. This episode is brought to you by Papa John's, 280 North River Avenue, right here in Holland. Give him a call, 616-355-7272. Southside Cuts, with two locations, 114 West 16th or 375 Columbia Avenue, 616-836-7502. They're open weekly 10 to 8. POS Compassion Club, located at 9730 Adams Street, Holland, Michigan. Get a hold of them, 616-772-9420, or visit their website at purewestclub.com. All right, so we are back. Again, we want to thank everybody for watching. We appreciate all you, everybody that supports the podcast.
Hey, Black River Studio. If you guys want to hear certain topics that we talk about, send in, you can email me or you can actually message me. Just reach out a topic that you guys want us to touch on, and trust me, we will touch on it.
Yes, we'll talk about anything.
We love interaction with people.
We're not here.
We love a good debate.
Yeah, and we're not scared to talk about anything.
No, we're not. So, as you just seen.
Yes, so we talk about whatever the hell we damn well please, and ain't nobody gonna stop us.
Can't nobody hold me.
Well, the only
down.
One that can stop us is God, and that's about it. So. But anyways, all right, well, we thank everybody for joining, and we will see you tomorrow with Javi. Javi, we'll see you tomorrow. Peace. Everybody have a good night.
Later, God bless.
Excellent. And we'll see y'all tomorrow.